Hey everyone, journey with me to a galaxy far, far away as we look back at the expanded universe, which filled our imaginations and kept the Star Wars franchise alive for decades before the likes of Rey and Kylo Ren debuted on the big screen. Journey with me into the legends of Star Wars. Up in Slave Quarters Row on the dusty planet that is farthest from, Anakin Skywalker had several playmates to spend his days with when he wasn't pod racing or working in his master Watto's shop. Among the group of friends were the humans Amy, Seek, and Melee, along with the Rodian Wald, but none was more faithful than Kitster Chachane Bane. Born 41 years before the Battle of Yavin, Kitster was the son of pirate and smuggler Raker Bane. Eventually, Raker's business caught the attention of the Hutt cartel, who raided his ship, kidnapping his wife and young son, selling them to slavers on Tatooine. During their time together in Mos Espa, Kitster and Anakin would go on many adventures together, including disguising themselves as Jawas in order to sneak into the estate of Gardula the Hutt in order to free a group of ghostling children, ethereal humanoids from the planet Datar. Kitster was also one of the few of Anakin's friends to support Anakin participating in the Bunta Eve pod race, serving as part of Anakin's pit crew alongside Wald, C-3PO, and R2-D2. After Anakin won the Bunta Eve pod race, he would leave some of his prize money to his best friend, who would use it to purchase a copy of Par Onthamm's Guide to Etiquette, which he would use to secure a position at the Three Moons Hotel in Mos Espa. By the time he had grown to adulthood, Kitster had saved enough credits to buy his freedom from the Hutts. Not much is known about Kitster's life during the Clone Wars and the rise of the Empire. Many believed him to have become a smuggler, following in his father's footsteps. In any case, Kitster was back in Mos Espa roughly a year and a half after the Battle of Yavin. He knew nothing about the true fate of his former playmate, believing, like many, that Anakin Skywalker had died during the Clone Wars. Kitster would try to better the lives of many of the slaves on Tatooine, often angering the slave owners. One such owner, Bandrick, even went as far as framing Kitster for the theft of a droid from a group of violent Jawas, sending the aggressive Junkers to seek retribution from the innocent Kitster. Luckily, a rogue Starhopper agreed to deal with the savage Jawas on Kitster's behalf, and out of gratitude received the pod racing helmet Anakin had worn many years before during the Bunta Eve. But the slaver Bandrick was not done with Kitster yet, framing him for the slave uprising at Jabba's palace. The rogue spacehopper once again came to Kitster's aid, but now Bandrick had paid off a moisture farmer to skip town long enough for Sont Toypo to rally a mob and implicate Kitster in the farmer's murder. For the third time, the spacehopper came to Kitster's defense, killing Toypo and locating the farmer to clear Kitster's name. For his trouble, the spacehopper received another gift, a droid brain built by Anakin Skywalker. Kitster would marry twice in his life, the first time to Ulda, who owned the old podracing arena in Mos Espa. This wouldn't last, however, as Kitster would fall in love with the arena's bartender, Tamora Spice. The pair would have two children, G and L.A. Kitster would lead the staff of the prominent Rendella estate, but by 8 years after the Battle of Yavin, the estate would foreclose, leaving Kitster unemployed. To provide for his family, Kitster took to auctioning off his own personal items, including a holocube of his old friend winning the Bunta Eve Classic. It was at one of these auctions, some 8.5 years after Yavin, that Kitster would meet the disguised daughter of his former friend, Leia Organa Solo, and her husband Han. The Solos had come looking for the Alderaanian painting Kill at Twilight, a rare piece of artwork after the destruction of Alderaan, one which hung in House Organa during Leia's youth, and also happened to hold key codes to the New Republic's Shadowcast communications network. When violence erupts at the auction house, Kitster, in an effort to preserve Kill at Twilight from Imperial forces, takes the painting and escapes into the desert on a swoop bike owned by Wald. Unfortunately, Kitster runs into a sandstorm and is forced to take refuge in a Jawa sandcrawler. When the sandcrawler is attacked by Tusken Raiders, Kitster is captured and taken as a sacrifice to the Valley of the Spirits, where an angry ghost had once slaughtered an entire Tusken village overnight with a glowing sword. Han and Leia show up in time to save Kitster and the key codes hidden within Killik Twilight. However, the artwork itself is lost to Imperial forces. Hearing Kitster talk about his childhood friend helps Leia come to terms with the fact that her father wasn't always evil, and had been, at the start, an innocent and talented young boy. This closure puts to rest Leia's fears of having children of her own, and the Solo twins, Jason and Jaina, are conceived not long after. For the full story on how Han and Leia met Kitster Bane, read Star Wars: Tatooine Ghost by Troy Denning. If you want more Legends content, click the thumbs up and subscribe buttons, and share this video so the knowledge gets out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all for the next Legend.